Much closer to home, there's another disturbing new threat facing children, this time on the Mexican side of the border. Alarmingly, more and more children are being pulled into illegal and risky business, oftentimes with the blessing of their parents. The children are just trying to help their needy families survive. In this exclusive story, Carmen Escobosa shows us a way of life that is stripping Tijuana's children of their innocence.
Tijuana has one of the fastest growing economies, and it is one of the border cities most frequented by foreign tourists. It has always kept its arms wide open to those coming from inner cities and beyond in search of a better life. Nevertheless, Tijuana has also one of the highest crime rates in the country and has now become one of the scenarios for a, you could say, new phenomenon in Mexico, known as narcomenudeo or narco retailing, hidden behind narco tienditas or narco shops.
Centros de distribución y venta de algún tipo de narcótico, hablando de, pues, de marihuana, cristal, heroína, que son las drogas de mayor consumo aquí en la frontera.
In these centers of distribution, customers are not greeted by drug lords, as you might think, nor are there huge sales.
Son pequeños envoltorios que se venden al menudeo, que se venden, te digo, en estos sitios, que los venden ya prácticamente como si vendieran chicles, golosinas.
You can get enough pot for a rolled cigarette for $1, methamphetamine capsules for $5.
Tristemente nos hemos encontrado con que en el sitio la mayor parte o incluso familias completas están prácticamente involucradas en la venta de droga al menudeo.
And the transactions, you will not believe this, are witnessed in some cases and handled in many others by the youngest at home, 5, 6, 7 year olds. Juan, as we will call him, is a father of 3 young children. He spends his days selling and distributing drugs at retail from his home, while everything is being witnessed by his own children.
Y ellos miran que agarro dinero. Ah, ellos miran que agarro dinero y pues a contarme, me ayudan. ¿Sabes qué? Aquí está esto, guarda eso. Si me miran a mí, voy. O cuando miran la policía, van y me dicen y así.
Nada más si miran y ven y eso, nada más así.
O nomás le avisa.
Sí, nada más.
Oye, ¿saben? ¿Tus compañeritos en la escuela saben? Nadie, no. ¿Verdad? ¿Y tú qué piensas de esto? No piensas. Qué bueno. ¿Y en qué año vas?
En primero.
Ay, qué grandote. ¿Y cómo te va?
Bien.
¿Sí? ¿Y cuando crezcas, qué quieres ser, mi amor? ¿Qué te gustaría ser?
Policía.
Pues qué bien.
A police officer? The sprouting question is, what would he then do to his own dad if he was a cop? Juan trusts that his children won't follow his example and that they are aware he only sells drugs because it is better paying than a maquiladora job, for instance.
A veces gano hasta 500 pesos a la semana, al día. Al día. Y en una fábrica no gano 500 pesos al día. De esos 500 pesos invierto 300 pesos. ¿Cuánto me gané? 200 pesos. Por la vez que se vende más. Chido.
But something Juan should consider is the fact that he adopted his tradition of selling drugs from his older sister. And his older sister adopted it from her mom, a practice that has now become a pattern, as you will see, according to files kept by PGR, which stands for Procuraduría General de la República, Mexico's version of DEA, Drug Enforcement Agency.
Familias enteras operan estos negocios. Este es uno de tantos casos en el que la madre e hija son sorprendidas en su domicilio y que son identificadas por los vecinos, personas que se dedican a vender o a abastecer a, adictos de pequeñas dosis de droga.
And while authorities try to put an end to this form of child corruption, the living reality in some streets of Tijuana, like this one's known as Zona Norte, seem to make it impossible.
Aquí al fondo está el callejón del infierno. Ahí. Este es otro lugar donde se reúne la gente para inyectarse o consumir cualquier tipo de droga.
Nada. Anda cosiendo. Siempre cosi, cosi, cosi. Ah, que está limpiando.
¿Cuántos años tiene, hija?
Cinco.
In a scenario like this one, authorities admit it is very difficult to keep children away from selling and distributing drugs or committing any other crime. After all, this is what they are exposed to practically since their first breath of air.
Nearly 300 federal agents were brought in from Mexico City to shut down all the narco tienditas they could find in Tijuana.